So I'm pretty sure the most arresting thing about this game, maybe apart from its title, is its box art. Because initially we're presented with this adorable animal in a bowler hat and a lantern. And you're like, what is he doing? But it's so, so cute. And then it's Raccoon Tycoon. So A, it rhymes, and B, it's got raccoons. And already you can tell this is not going to be the type of raccoon who is foraging in your dustbin for scraps. This is going to be an adorable raccoon, and he probably wants to make money. So to say I'm so excited for this game. It's one I've been looking at for quite some time, and to have it here is actually super exciting, because everything anthropomorphized is just better. So it's not a particularly large box. It is quite deep. Let's see what the side looks like. So on the side, it has some very beautiful art. You guys can see beautiful raccoon. Very, very cool. And then on the back, let's see what it's about. So Raccoon Tycoon, so it says, become a tycoon in this fast, fun game of commodity speculation and town development. Ooh, all those things. And initially, I can't help but be drawn in by the art. You can see pictures here of all the different characters on their cards, and it is stunning. Playtime-wise, this is supposed to take 60 to 90 minutes, and that's for 2 to 5 players. I like that it goes to 5. Complexity-wise, it's a 2 out of 5. Okay, seems easy enough. Strategy wise, it's 4 out of 5 castles. So apparently there's a lot of strategy. And this is for ages 8+. Yeah, already this looks cool, right? Like, I think you're either going to know if this is your game or not by just looking at the cover. So let's hop inside and we'll see what's in there. And then we'll take a look at the components a little bit more carefully right at the end. So you can see what's actually in here. Whoops, that came off actually quite well. So the first thing we see is Raccoon Tycoon official tycoon handbook. I like that. This isn't a rule book, it's a tycoon handbook. Not very big, it's a very good size, and it's got that cute artwork on it as well. So welcome to Astoria, and then here's how you play. The start player tokens, there's money, cash money, woo woo. Game board, how all these things work, little tokens. Money, setting everything up, cool, gamer. The font is lovely, it's really easy to read and straightforward. There is a good bit of text in here. There's examples, plenty of examples actually. That's a lot of text, but not too bad. And they're at least sectioned, so that should make it easy to find your way back. Game end, and there's also an option for a longer game, which is kind of cool. What's the rest of this for? Here's how you score. There's optional rules as well, and then some credits, and then an appendix for all the buildings. So it's going to be building tokens. And on the back of it, aha, yes, very, very smart indeed. It has a reminder of the things you can do on your turn. I love this old green colour. It just fits so perfectly with it. It reminds me of that painting of the dogs sitting around the table playing cards. There's something about it that just feeds into that in my mind. Okay, so here we go. It looks like we've got the player. We've got a board anyway. Whoop. Oh, I see. I'm with you, game. Now, it's not a huge board, but my camera is not particularly big at the best of times. You can see it's not wide, but it's tall. So if we start at the bottom, so you can see there are places for your buildings and for your stack of buildings. There, your town deck goes here, your railroad and your railroad deck. So obviously it's going to be cards. And then here at the top, it looks like it's the prices for all of the different commodities. So there's luxuries, there's goods, there's coal, iron, wood, and wheat. I love the colouring in this board. It's beautiful, the fact that this is nice and bright like that, and these are all part of a picture. I think that's really cool. Other very special feature of this game board, is, see the back? That's cloth. There's some kind of cloth. It's well taken care of, it's treated well on the back. This is a very nice board, and actually kind of super compact. So next then we have much cardboard for making tokens. Yeah, so here we go. All the different ones of these, but I'll have a look at these closer now in a second. And then beneath that, you can see there's an insert. It's a really nice insert. So we've got our decks of cards, some monies. I'll have a look at that in a sec. Oh my God, that money is nice. And we've got a first player marker, which we may as well look at next. He's huge. Look at him. Look at him. So that's the first player token. Yeah. Everybody loves a good raccoon. Right, so let's have a closer look at some of these pieces. So the first sheet we have are of tokens 1 to front. So we have wood and coal and such. This is really, really thick board. So we'll pop one out. Yeah, it's chunky. I like the way it's white around the edges as well. It makes everything stand out a bit better. So we have a couple of sheets of these. So there's going to be actually a relatively good number of goods for you to be able to buy. So we have the wheat and the luxury goods and then goods. And I think it was called iron. So these are really good. There seems to be a tray for them to go into the insert, but no necessarily bags. Okay, so let's see what's next. So next up, we have these tiles. So they're board one front. They're all building tiles, it looks like. And these are beautiful. It's the same color as the top of the game board. Yet again, really, really thick cardboard, really nice coloring, really easy to read all the iconography. Pop one out. Yeah, it's this lovely, big, chunky tile. There's not too much popping out, but there seems to be a good number of these. And they also seem to kind of do things for you that will give you extra victory points and whatnot, as predicted. The artwork is great, actually. I really, really love this. These are very clear without being dull. So that's awesome. So let's see what's next. So the next thing, of course, is this wad of cash people. It actually doesn't feel far away from cast. I'm actually reluctant to take it out of the piece of plastic because I like it in it. The coolest thing, obviously, it says is in dog we trust, because of course we should all trust in dogs. And this is from the Bank of Astoria. And these are really, really cool. And let's see how what I'll break it. So they're on some five. It's as if five. They're laminated, so they're like, they're really nice cash, like really nice money. Most people have gone silver coins these days. These are fabulous. They're so tactile. They really just feel like playing with a wad of cash. They don't feel like paper. They feel more laminate than that. And I love the badger on the front of it. And they're just so cool. That's a really, really nice touch. So the last thing in the box are these two decks of cards. So we'll look at the less interesting looking one first. So these are price and production cards, as it says. Yeah, they're all blue. These are really nice cards, actually. They're really quite, I want to call them linen finish, but I don't know if they are, but they're very close. As in they're nice and they're solid. So they have price on them and production on them. Not sure how this works, but they vary. So obviously this is how we get prices for things. So two halves, I'm curious to see how that works. Maybe you sell them for one, you produce for the other. Mm-hmm. Maybe they're multi-use cards. I'm just guessing terribly. You probably know more than me. And then the other side, we have cards for Raccoon Town. And then we have Raccoon Railroad Tycoon cards. So the Tycoon cards seem to be the one with the animals on them. So it's Skunk Works Railroad. Oh, God, these are so pretty. That is amazing. And then they all have the victory points on the bottom. These are just stunning. Oh, my God. I cannot wait to play this. That's just so cute. Look at this. I think even if you aren't an animal person, you'll find at least one animal in here that you're kind of drawn to because they're just that cool. Fabulous. And then these are obviously the places in the town. So we got Blackfriar, Bridgewater, so plus two with the railroads. Oh, cool. So you're going to want to connect these with your railroad kind of things you're doing. Trinity. Very cute. Yet again, lovely cards. Really, really nice. I love the filigree on them. I love how much effort's been put into all of the design of these cards. And actually everything in the game itself, it all looks incredibly luxe, doesn't it? Okay, let's put it all back together again. So this is actually a really lovely insert. So all of the tokens and things are going to go in here once I've popped them out, which we aren't going to do right now, so they should just fit in there for the time being. All going according to plan. Or if I did them in the right order, that might have helped, perhaps. Yeah, there we go. How did these fit? Look at that. See, there was a plan all along. Oops. So then it also means that no matter what round you stored this, all of your stuff would stay inside the box. That's great thinking, actually. I love when people think like that about how you're going to keep your game. And pretend that didn't happen. So we just took everything back inside the box. Look, it fits so neatly. It's perfect. And I love that they thought about what way around you might store your box, because it doesn't seem to matter in this case. It'll fit. Either way, nothing will fall out. So yeah, I'm super excited to try Raccoon Tycoon. What about yourselves? Have you played it already? Are you lured in by cute, adorable creatures? And maybe a hint of finance? well, it's definitely worked on me. So you've been watching Board Game Inquisition and I've just unboxed Raccoon Tycoon. I hope you like and subscribe so you can get updates about my future videos. There'll be more unboxings and reviews and such. It's kind of fun. And I love having more people to tell about board games, of course. So until next time, take care, everybody. Bye-bye.